learned something new today. Through the shading, moving through.
For me, the studio is like gold. It's worth more than money. There's so much energy in this place, the genius that comes out of this place.
We have open fields in all areas to express ourselves. We do it through music, we do it through guitar, we do it through drawing, through painting.
It's just amazing that what comes out of here. You know, like from people who have schizophrenia, depression, manic depression, or other illnesses.
I have suffered depression for most of my adult life. And you come here and you're given a voice. You're given, my self-esteem has gone way up.
It's a great community here. On my own, I have trouble working on my own. Being depressed a lot, I'm not always motivated, but coming here provides a structure, a time and a place to work. And so I apply myself and I leave feeling terrific.
Please, please, please open up more of these spaces for people so that we're important and we start to feel important. We stand up straighter.
I was in the Senate for about 22 years. The Senate committee that I chaired did about a three-year study on the mental health issue in the country, and we wrote a report that was really the first national report on mental health. In my own case, my older sister became steadily more depressed over time. Sought psychiatric help, got antidepressants, didn't work. Ultimately became anorexic. Finally had an attempted suicide that, as a pure miracle, failed. Everybody on the committee had a connection with mental health somewhere in their family. That's what ultimately led us to write the report.
Once you have this diagnosis of a mental illness, people don't value your opinion. You lose your voice in society.
I had a depression, but I didn't know I had other things like Asperger's syndrome and ADD and explosive disorders, like getting angry all the time. I didn't know I had that until later.
You know, with mental illness, there's so much ugliness in our lives. You know, the stigma, the self-maintenance that we have to go through in order to function out of our community. So for me to come in here, and I know what's happening to everybody here, how much pain, how much loneliness, the alienation, but I look at the paintings and they're filled with beauty.
Without this place, a lot of people would I don't know what to say, but this place is an outlet, and it's like a family. You feel safe here. You go out in the real world. Kids now, they don't respect nobody. They think of mental illness. There's no education for a mental illness. When I was going to school, dealing with my problems, I was in special class, and they just disregard you. You know, they never think of you. But here, you could think clearly. You could paint. You could daydream. You could listen to music. You could play music. You could do photography. You could do almost anything you want to do here without being judged.
It's a beautiful wonderful studio to be in. It's warm and inviting, and there's always love to be found in the studio.
I spent years battling with symptoms, and well, now I have the odd day where I walk down the street a free man.
Painting through the pain and the fear.